Hello, welcome to all. Let us discuss something about high blood pressure. That means some aspects of high blood pressure only. High blood pressure, medically known as hypertension. I want to quote one popular author's wordings. One Mr. Kaplan, he was a medical director in US. He has written a book on high blood pressure. In that book, he has told almost all individuals do develop high blood pressure at one stage of work or other during their lifetime. So almost all individuals are vulnerable to develop high blood pressure. Now let us see how lifestyle causes high blood pressure and correction of lifestyle, how it helps to control high blood pressure. That's a good thing. The lifestyle causes high blood pressure. Controlling, like correcting lifestyle, gives remedy for high blood pressure. See, first, sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary means sitting all along without doing any physical work. Another one, high body weight, excess body weight, high fat, then behavior, then anger. These are all causing high blood pressure. These are all causing some basement for develop high blood pressure. What is happening actually? What do we nowadays? We take more food, but we do less work. What is the stress? Stress, everybody has got stress. The smoking contains lot of troubleshooting elements. The smoke contains a lot of troubleshooting elements. Most important culprit is nicotine, which is related to high blood pressure. So you have to avoid 6 items. That is, yes. First S is sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary means lazy. Somebody is lazy, they are more vulnerable to develop high blood pressure. The world is not for lazy people. That is, sedentary lifestyle you avoid. Then stress, you reduce the stress. Another is salt. If you keep on consuming high amount of salt, processed food, packed food, where salt is added not as an additive, it is added as a preservative. So the excess salt also shoots up your blood pressure. Then spirit, what is that? Excess alcohol. So alcohol, if you give up totally, it is well and good, but at least you reduce the quantum. The Western literature say 2 drinks per day or 1 drink per day for women and all. Better to totally abstain from alcohol. Another time, you sleep well, less screen time, good amount of sleep. Now everything is reversed. You should switch off all the gadgets, that is television, smartphone, everything, at least 1 hour before you go to sleep. So what is a lifestyle? I will classify 3. Lifestyle, first one is diet. Second one is activities. Third one is behavior. Coming to the lifestyle. I told you have the stress lifestyle. Another one, more and more sitting job. Whatever you do, you should have a separate exercise program. You need not have enormous physical activity or strenuous exercise or marathon or pull-ups and all. Even level ground walking 30 to 40 minutes will do. Then you can do some muscle strengthening exercises. Then coming to diet, what we do? We take more and more salt, fat, oil, processed food, whatever the latest food, pizza, burger, whatever it is. These are all very harmful for all diseases, including diabetes and high blood pressure. You reduce salt, fat, sweets, totally avoid soft drinks. Take more fiber cereals and vegetables. Then eat slowly without screen or gadgets. Nowadays it is a fashion. They look at the mobile phone and they take food, or they view TV and take food. You avoid that. Then keep on serving the food on the plate by wife or somebody. So ultimately you forget how much food you have taken. So whatever you want to take, put it on the plate at a time. So you will come to understand how much food you are confused. Then relaxing workout, outdoor walking, Then mindful walking, mindful walking. Stress reduction practice. Stress reduction practice is meditation. Meditation. Then bottom line, the small things will make very big achievement. High BP caused by stress and lifestyle. When you correct this, it will be better. Let us discuss about combination of two dreadful diseases. That is high blood pressure and diabetes. How high blood pressure goes hand in hand with diabetes. See, suppose you have diabetes, or suppose you are a pre-diabetic, or suppose you have a risk for developing diabetes, your risk for developing high blood pressure is 2 to 3 times more than non-diabetic individuals. Okay? So, suppose if you have a diabetes, your chance of getting high blood pressure also gets doubled. That is, what are the risks? All the people do develop high blood pressure. Just before some time, I told, chance to get high BP. What is happening really? The blood sugar remains high. So there is more insulin in the body, but insulin is not working satisfactorily. There are some factors which prevent the insulin to work normally. This is called insulin resistance. So body has insulin, but it has insulin resistance also. So increased amount of insulin and high blood sugar do develop inflammation. You know very well, inflammable. Inflammable means almost setting fire. So it causes inflammation. Some small obstructive substances called plaques. These plaques are thick material. It blocks the circulation of the blood. So suppose the lumen is 100% open, if the plaque is developed, the percentage comes down. This is the way they develop artery obstruction, blood tube obstruction. So you might have heard of this heart attack, they do angiogram. One blood tube causes 80% block, 70% block, 60% block and all. What is the cause of these blocks? Caused by plaques. These plaques are caused by cholesterol, high blood pressure, diabetes, excess body weight, excess fat, all these things join together and form these things. Don't get satisfied with one recording of blood pressure. What is the best thing is, office value may be erroneously, that means wrongly high. So you better ask your staff to record blood pressure while the patient is waiting outside. 2 or 3 times you take an average value. That is a different one. Another thing, you can have an apparatus at home. That is called home blood pressure monitoring. Try to maintain the blood pressure as 140-90 without any drug. If they have diabetes, your target is 130/80, not 140/90. So maintain blood pressure at 130/80 when the patient has got diabetes is very, very, very important. And diabetes and high blood pressure share common connections or common components. That is high fat, high body weight, sedentary lifestyle. Another thing, high blood pressure, I told, it is a salt-related disease. Here, high blood pressure in diabetes, salt is sensitive. Why? They are taking excess salt. Here also, they are taking excess salt. What is the difference? Important difference is there. I told there is insulin resistance. When kidneys excrete, kidneys push out the sodium chloride, the one part of the kidney tube reabsorbs salt again. So this reabsorption is minimized when the patient has got insulin resistance. So diabetic people, once they excrete sodium chloride, more sodium chloride is reabsorbed. That is very important one. So then these things join together. Coming to diabetic kidney disease, diabetes and high blood pressure damages kidney earlier than individual components when it exists in differently. When they join together, developing diabetic kidney disease are multiplied. Sudden loss of vision, eyesight, sudden loss of vision also more common when these two components are more. Another thing, don't forget the medications. You may read a lot of things from magazines. You do some this, that and all. Then you know you don't need to take medicines for diabetes or high blood pressure. In the TV, hospitals are telling. So many people are giving advice in WhatsApp and all. Nowadays, you can go through that. Don't listen to Professor Google and Professor WhatsApp. Listen to your doctor. That is always better. Healthy diet. I told about that. You have to curb carbohydrates, improve protein, medium, restrict fat. Fruits, fiber, cereals, it is important. Salt, then alcohol, absolutely no smoking. Smoking has got more relevance to diabetes also. This nicotine increases insulin resistance. It interferes with the mechanism of action of insulin. So smoking is diabetogenic. Smoking by itself can cause diabetes. So avoiding smoking gives a lot of remedy for you. Then make exercise a routine. Wherever you are traveling, you have been traveling all around the globe, you have to spare some time for exercise. It is a must. Aerobics, then muscle strengthening, I told. Just brisk walking for 30 to 40 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes muscle strengthening exercise, even at bed. Then relief from distress. Relief from distress. Don't react too much about your safety, your money, all these other aspects. Don't worry too much. It adds more harm. Then check your body weight. Then another one more important thing. Usually during our sleep, there is a reduction. Spend time with the children. Spend time with your wife. Spend time with your family. You spend some time with the elder citizen in the home. That all these things will relieve blood pressure and it will keep you in a healthy stage. So down with high blood sugar and high blood pressure. Thank you.